big baits, bit of burley, going back in the current, gotta love it. Ooh. Yes, there we go. Geez, that's a nice snapper in a harbour. Whether you're watching this episode of the ITM Fishing Show for pure entertainment, inspiration, or even information, you've got ITM to thank because they're bringing it to you free. It's free. Well, it is the middle of winter, would you believe? And where we are right now is in the far north. We've got our new NWS Davy craft on the back, which is going to be the perfect craft for exploring these inner harbour shallow waters. Throughout the course of the day, we're going to be exploring this harbour, and we're probably not going to be fishing any more than 5 or 10 metres deep. And this spot is my favourite spot, and that is a spot that I've never fished before.
Not only is this a new location for me, it's the first time fishing in my new boat, and we've got some new gear to try out. But before we can see how it all goes, we've got to get some bait.
Oh, you look right here, right here. Well, we've just put the boat in, about to launch, and we thought, well, we'll try and catch a few piper. Apparently there's a few piper here. Oh, man. So the basic plan here is we're just sort of walking the net out. Hopefully those piper that we saw on the surface are still in here. We'll run the net around, pull it up onto the beach. All going according to plan, we're going to have the best fresh bait we could expect. And that would be one heck of a start to our harbour fishing mission. Okay, come this way. come this way, Piper. Look at them out here. I mean, this is awesome. Blair's struggling with that net. I'm going to have to go give him a hand. I'm going to have to go my aunties, I don't care.
Somehow I've ended up on the beach end. Don't know how that happened, but I'm not complaining. A lot of piper just been busting up all through this bay. Well, you see them out here. There's a big eruption over there. Probably kingfish. Quite often see kingfish in here. Usually they're small, but occasionally you get really big ones. There's some in here.
Start walking that rope in, mate.
These are the guys that we're after. These little wee piper. And we've basically created a bag, and we're just going to use the beach to cut them off. And we're just going to pull them up onto the beach here, and it looks like we got some bait, boys. Now, having never fished here before, we just took this opportunity as soon as we saw the piper to get some fresh bait. And seeing this much piper right next to the boat ramp tells me there's a lot of food in this harbour. And we all know what eats piper. That's right, big snapper and kingfish.
Just
swim away.
Get
him there. Yes! Right, I'm gonna go grab the boat so we can get the live bait. Get out of there. Now, what we've got in here is a real treat, live piper now. It's pretty hard to keep piper alive, but I've got a live bait tank as one of the features on the centre console boat here, and I didn't suspect the first time to be using a live bait tank would have piper in it. So kingfish will eat these, snapper will eat them, and obviously if there's so much of them here, that's what the local food is. So I'm looking forward to using you little fellas. Well, right here as we're heading out, it's only like 5 metres deep, and that's the depth of most of this harbour that I have never fished before. That's why we've got this guy with us. That's Darwin Pippany. He's a Far North local and oyster farmer, and he's gonna lead us right to the Mabro. Right, let's get out there. Look at this, it's the middle of winter. The winterless north truly is the winterless north today. Up here. What do you reckon, bro? We'll just do a couple of drifts around here?
Well, you can either do a drift, but it's good to sit here.
Anchor up.
And wait for them to come down.
Okay, bit of burley.
Yeah, bro.
Can't argue with old school, bro.
Cool, bro.
Can't argue with old school. Rightio then. Just on my Furuno here, it shows a little bit of a hole over there. You don't have a Furuno on there, I take it?
No, my Furuno's in here.
He's
So here it is, the usual deadly burley combination, a wobbly burley pot and some of our king salmon burley, which is just minced up salmon frames. And I don't know what it is about this stuff, perhaps it's the oil content in it, but it drives the fish crazy. I'm just putting it out over the front here, because you can see how much current we've got. The current's really roaring, and we don't want that rope getting in our road, because these 20 pound snappers that Darwin's telling us about to come along, we don't want them getting tangled around the burley pot. Here we go, more boy! Oh, that's all right, Tim, eh?
It's a snapper.
It's a snapper.
Told you.
Oh, mate, I'm gonna have to get my act together and get some baits on there, boy.
Yeah.
Going old school.
Talking about snaps, mate. This is how you do it.
Hey, there's only enough room for one presenter here, all right, bro? Local presenter.
You want my rod, bro?
Yeah.
I'm fighting with the current and the big snap I got on. Some colour.
Oh yeah! Look at that puppy out of 5 metres of water, just in the middle of nowhere on the sand. Like, I've got the kick-ass Furuno here in the boat, which of course has led me to so many snapper, but that one there, I didn't use the Furuno, I used local Māori whala! Cha!
Come on, baby. Here she is.
Oh, way to go. Getting mate, just stop here. Down. You all right? Are you gonna, you want a net?
No net. How's that?
Oh, sweet, bro.
Hey, that's
look
only
at
a
that.
Little one.
Now that is exactly as you've seen it. We've just stopped here on the sand. Darwin's thrown out a bait, boom. How much weight have you got on there? You need quite a bit of weight to get down here, eh?
Yeah,
I better check out this fella's rig.
Check out the merry boy.
Check out his
local
rig,
knowledge.
Eh? Local knowledge, bro. Woo! Swallowed it?
How's that?
Oh yeah, it's bleeding from the gills,
yeah,
which
bro.
Makes it a keeper. That's fine, mate. We've got to take a few back.
Yeah.
Feed the whānau.
Yeah, bro. Now we need the boys to get some. I don't want to be the camera take the show.
And that fella there, just float back in the current, kicking around, doing his thing. Oh, look at this one in the current there. What a beauty. Oh, yeah, okay. That's my live fighter. Click it into gear, let it load up. Sorry, mate. Never get in the way of a man striking his snapper. Here he goes! Here he goes! Oh, beauty! So you've got a running sinker on there. I see you've got a big sinker for this current here, eh? Bit of a local trick.
It's a local trick.
With this current, getting your sinker, your bait down on the bottom, waving around in the current. Well, it's working all right for this, bro.
Some colour. There she goes. More colour. Might be about the same size as the last one.
It's a handy one to get, mate. That's a handy size.
There she goes.
Oh, look at them in the current. Bloody beauty. How many ounces of lead are you using?
As long as it can sit in the bottom.
No, that's not an answer. Come on.
That's not an answer. But I know. We'll have to check it out when I get it in, eh?
That's another nice one, mate.
There we go.
That's a blooming beaut.
The first one's the second one.
Inside the harbour. Oh, see, now you just put it back out and pulled it in again.
This little fella here might be eating my oysters.
How far away is your oyster farm, bro?
Well, it's only about a kilometre to my left.
You see any snappers and kingies swimming around your oyster farm?
Oh, sometimes you'll see a school of about 200.
Kingfish?
Snappers.
200 snappers?
Snappers.
You see them?
Yeah, you see them in about a foot of water. And then you get the mullet jumping over the top of the rails, and then you get the big bow waves of the kingies heading up there chasing all the mullet around. And
yeah. I've seen that place.
Have you?
Yeah, I dream about it most nights. And there's all the oysters you can eat too, bro. And that give you another different sort of dream. Too many oysters.
Yeah. Just don't want to end up with a gout like me. Too much seafood.
There we go, the proof's in the pudding, the old running sinker. So I've grabbed about a 3 ounce bit of lead and I'm going back to a rig that I used to use when I was a kid fishing on the Manukau Harbour, which was quite similar to this really, in that there was a lot of current and sort of dirty shallow water. And hey, it worked 20 years ago and we've just seen that it still works today. Now another thing that's old school about my rig, nice slab of mullet. I'm going to go full old school, running sinker rig, slab of mullet. I'm just going to drop it back down to the bottom there, and in about 2, 3, 1, there you go, bottom. That's the bottom. It's right there. Oh, hello. Hello. Pick it up with the rod on him, mate.
Hello.
He's on fire.
Mate.
What can I say? I'm being taught a lesson. Old school. That's a nice, that's more of an eating sort of size. And that one had plenty of grunt, eh?
Yeah, a lot of grunt for that. Oh, look, and I can let them go. He's hooked in the mouth.
Joyce.
Woohoo!
Nice work, bro.
Yeah, that's a little bit little. I'll let this one go. Here he goes. Oh, he's gone. He's gone straight there.
Hey, what's the story? These guys are a joke.
I don't know.
Hey, look, it's a well-known thing. You don't turn up to someone else's house and start showing off and being a clowner. You don't get invited back. I'm letting the man show us around. Plenty of time. Now, Darwin's obviously catching fish. He's got a chili bin, which is good, but this stuff, some salt ice, because of course if we're going to take any fish, we want to keep them in as good a condition as possible. So I've got some spare here, and let's see if we can not make a mess of this. Ready? Oh, straight in the guts, boy! He's catching everything today. Well, I hope you're enjoying this episode. But if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv. Well, where we are is in a far north harbour. The tide's going out, so now we're probably only sitting in about 3 metres of water. We're catching snapper hand over fist. And we come here to try a few new things. New fishing rods, brand new boat, but we're catching our fish. Old school. Big baits, bit of burley, going back in the current, gotta love it.
Ooh! Got some.
Woohoo! Now, not only is this the first time out for this boat, this is the first time I've used this rod. It's in fact a prototype Matt Watson signature range rod, and so far it feels pretty good. 10 to 15 kg spin, and it's using secret new technology. You'll notice like how thin and light this thing is, yet there's heaps of grunt in it, and it feels good. I might just, look at that, cameraman, fisherman, rod salesman. Oh, oh, a bite over there. Go, go, go. Yeah, boy! Which camera? Oh, check this one too. Oh no, this one's smoking out too. Oh mate, what do we do? Oh no, I lost it. This was the big one as well. Damn, that was smoking. Oh, if that had been in freeze pool, you know, I might put it into freeze pool so if we get a bite, it comes back. Oh man! So obviously that has come through in waves like that, eh? See, these guys have obviously come through, picked up our burley trail, and all at once.
These guys are going to catch up to me.
Snapper right here, mate. That's something here, plenty of time. Look at that, there's the old bit of bait. See if I do the old net job as well. Yes, there we go. Geez, that's a nice snapper in a harbour. I mean, all of that was old school, just like I was a kid, except the snapper are bigger. Mind you, we did get the odd 20 pounder in the Manukau Harbour, and look at that, he's just hooked in the lip.
So I'm just going to roll that nicely out there. Look at that. In the beautiful winter's afternoon sun in the far north. I'm not even going to bring him in and he'll just... away he goes, just like that. Oh, is that, yep, that the other... Oh, the other rod's going. Oh, got him on. Oh, man. That's had a real good run on it before. Real good run.
Just tell. That last one.
Okay, I'll just trust that that fish is hooked. I'm just gonna leave that there. Okay, you stay there, snapper. Stay there.
Swing it on round, mate.
That'll be nice, that shot. Righty, I'll let you deal with that because I think I've still got a snapper on over there. Oh, and this one happens to be also first fish for this rod, which is also a Matt Watson Signature Range rod, made with the same technology, although, as you can see, this is designed for an overhead, just like my little Shimano Trinidad 14 here. There you go, catches them by itself. Some conditions may apply. Nice eater, this one, isn't it? Yeah, one goes out as one comes in. Back from whence he came.
This one's wrong.
Just 5 meters away. And while you let that one go, I'll bring this one over. Look at that. Nicely, nicely. That fella, being a little wee bit smaller, we might keep. Because these winter snapper are in just such good condition. I mean, I've had a change of heart. That fella looks so nice. He's going home. Oh, that's gonna be mean. Swam straight down the lens of the underwater camera. Oh, yep, both getting bites. Oh, and that one's on over there. Next wave of fish has come through. Let's have a look at the old mullet head. That's where the bait runner is great. Look at that, feeding out, feeding out. Oh, hello. That's how the system works. The old Bait Runner 8000 coupled with this 10 to 15 kilo MWS spin rod. Beautiful, isn't it?
Just
oh, yeah, because look, see, another nice end. We've got one coming up right here, Dave. He's hit that piper in the middle, boom, to crush it, and then they suck him in sideways where Josh's hook has caught him cleanly in the corner of the mouth. Yee-hoo. Oh, hello. Got him on. You take that one, bro. Oh, which way? You're over. Oh, lost him, we bugger. Oh, there's my snapper sitting there. He's not a baddie. It's all going, mate. It's all going. Nice. Mmm. The old whole mullet head. It's another nicey. Oh, fit him in the net. You can fit in there. No worries. Look at that. Jesus, another nicey. And he's just crunched that mullet head. That's where the bait runner was just so good, letting him take it, and then he's got it down that big, big, powerful jaws of his. And fortunately, there's a hook just in the corner of the mouth, so I can roll that out and let him go. And that fella there will just float back in the current, kicking around, doing his thing. Oh, look at him swimming in the current there. What a beauty. That's my live fighter. Click it into gear, let it load up, and... Sorry, mate. Never get in the way of a man striking his snapper. That rod's nice, look at that. There's so much grunt down here. It's quite parabolic, but it's got plenty of grunt. That's all right, Dave. Got him. Oh, give it another crank. Oh, you bugger. No, we'll go back. Bugger it up. I'll just concentrate on this one here, eh? That's, digging around down there, fighting away, just smooth as. Oh, look at that, and his mate's just over here. Okay, we'll try this time.
Lose him out of the rod holder. Yeah, got him.
Woohoo! Look at that.
I'll get. Oh, geez, which one am I going to take? Oh, no. I've got them both. I've got them both. Hang on. Wind this one in the right. You got that one, mate? Yeah. Cheers, bro.
That's not a bad one, too.
That was a nice scrap. I'll just jump straight on over to the old half mullet version over here.
How big's that one?
Yeah, it's a nicey. It's a nicey. That was on the old fresh piper. And this fella here is on fresh mullet. Just reminded me, mate, saying hook well. No secrets on the ITM Fishing Show. The hooks are a VMC hook. Very strong. Oh, look at this fella. I might just be able to let this fella go without even lifting him out of the water. And if I just quickly, bada boom, away he goes. I'm just left with what was half of a mullet. Okay, now I'm looking for my biggest, most lively looking piper. Volunteer for active duty. On my live bait hook here, it's just a VMC one, but it's just a nice small size, and I'm popping it in there right through the upper jaw. And that fella there will just float back in the current, kicking around, doing his thing. And I'm sure if there's a kingfisher around, it's going to eat it.
We hope you enjoyed this episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.